Power amplifier, or PA, is core component in wireless communication devices such as mobile phones or base stations. Many PAs are designed to be used with DPD, so it's important to measure PA performance under DPD enabled. In this video, we look at the things to know when measuring PA with DPD. PA non-linearity causes impairments such as gain compression or third-order distortion, especially when power gets high. Those impairments directly impact to the key performance metrics such as EBM or ACPR. When power level is relatively low, PA mostly operates in linear fashion. EBM and ACPR are pretty good with almost no visible problems. As power gets higher, the spectral regrowth in adjacent channels degrades ACPR dynamic range, in this example by 18 dB. Also, the gain compression causes constellation point spreading and EBM gets far worse. Those are the impact of PA's distortion due to nonlinearity. If you enable DPD while maintaining same power level, you can see ACPR and EBM are significantly improved, and it's a lot closer to the linear operation. So how does DPD do its trick? You can think about PA input and output power relationship. When PA is perfectly linear, you can expect constant gain across all power range, all the way to the top. If we plot XY graph with input and output power, the slope represents PA gain. If PA is linear, the graph is a straight line like this. In reality, however, PA is non-linear device. When signal goes through PA, the gain cannot be sustained, especially in high power region, in upper right area in the graph. The line goes down compared to the straight line. This is called as gain compression. If we have knowledge of the nonlinear characteristics of PA, we can increase input power level before it goes into PA to compensate gain compression. As a result, the PA output is linear again, at least in theory. This is the very basic concept of pre-distortion. When this power pre-adjustment is done digitally in baseband, this is called as digital pre-distortion, or DPD. One important thing to remember for DPD is effect of oversampling. DPD tries to apply inverse response for nonlinear PA. As we previously saw, third-order distortion appears in adjacent channels. So, if we want to improve ACPR, the pre-distorted waveform bandwidth also needs to cover adjacent channels. This requires the waveform to have wider bandwidth by applying oversampling. In this example, we have 100 MHz bandwidth 5G NR waveform. The base sample rate is 122.88 MHz. Since there is no third-order bandwidth coverage, the DPD doesn't improve ACPR performance. After applying 3 times higher sample rate, you can get ACPR improvement with DPD. This also means the measurement instruments such as signal generators and signal analyzers needs to cover over 3 times of carrier bandwidth. If you want to measure PA with DPD for 100 MHz bandwidth, you need 300 MHz bandwidth supported on signal generators and analyzers. To generate inverse distortion, the DPD algorithm calculates model of PA nonlinear characteristics. There are several DPD modeling algorithms you can choose from. The most simple and intuitive form of DPD model is lookup table, or LUT. LUT compares instantaneous output amplitude and phase against input amplitude, then builds table of inverse characteristics. Waveform will be pre-distorted using this table. However, nonlinear devices like PA don't behave consistently against power level. There is so-called memory effect that causes inconsistency depending on the past state of power. As bandwidth gets wider, memory effect becomes more apparent. Volterra series and/or memory polynomial are more sophisticated form of DPD models, which takes memory effect into account for DPD modeling. Those models are both known as memory models. Volterra series is the most general memory model, but it's computationally intensive, while memory polynomial model is focused on special cases and it's more efficient. In contrast, LUT only look at the instantaneous response, hence it's called as memory-less models. Let's look at the measurement setup. We have Keysight VXG vector signal generator delivering modulated signal to PA, and UXA signal analyzer measures output of PA. It's a good practice to insert attenuator to the PA output to prevent damages to the analyzer's input port with high output power from PA. 10 MHz reference output and trigger output from VXG are connected to UXA's respective inputs to establish timing and frequency synchronization. N9055EM0E Power Amplifier test application controls both of the UXA and VXG. Now let me switch to the UXA screen. First, we're gonna prepare the waveform file using the Pathwave Signal Generation Desktop. So go into the 5GNR mode and select the uplink and also select the predefined 100 MHz 30K SCS QPSK. And that's pretty much ready, but we want to change the sample rate. So we multiply the base sample rate times 3. And so that gives us the wider bandwidth coverage. And also we adjust the waveform length to 1 millisecond. So it's one subframe. And also we look at the CCDF curve and peak power is 11 dB almost. It's a little bit too high, so we use the crest factor reduction capability to reduce the peak power. And now the peak power is reduced down to the 8 dB. So now we are ready to export waveform. So we set the file name and export it. Now switch to the UXA screen and then go into the power amplifier mode and select the power amplifier and press OK. So now we switch to the power amplifier mode. Then first thing we have to do is set up the measurement standard we use. So we prepare the 5GNR uplink and 100 MHz. So we select that. And that will automatically configure the measurement accordingly. Then next step is connect to the signal generator. So we have connected to the signal generator. And then select the waveform. We just exported the waveform. So we select that one and then press select. This will transfer to the waveform file to the VXG. So the measurement will automatically start. And now we are making the AM, NPM measurement as well as the ACP measurement. So next step is to set up the power amplifier output and gain and those configure to set the power level. So now we set the power control mode to the PA output, and now the PA output is set to the minus 10 dBm, and that's a linear region. So the ACP looks pretty clean. The ACPR is minus 43.8 dB, and now we increase the power PA output power to plus 9 dB. And now we have the little bit worse ACP, the increased noise level in the adjacent channel. Now we are ready to enable DPD. Go into DPD tab and select the DPD model. We're going to use a memory polynomial model. And then turn on the DPD. So DPD's model is extracted and the VXG is now generating pre-distorted waveform. And now you can see the ACPR improved minus 45.7 dBc. And so that's the impact of DPD. Let's look at the EBM, turn off DPD, then switch to the 5GNR mode. And now we are making the 3.3% EBM measurement. And going back to the PA mode, and actually the setup we had 5GNR mode can be coupled in the PA mode. So once you couple the setting, then you can make the same EBM measurement inside of PA mode. And by enabling DPD again, then you can actually see the demodulated EBM is improved to 1.8%. You can see how DPD improved both ACPR and the EBM. Once you're happy with the DPD result, you can go to Save menu and select the DPD result to export the DPD model and select Save As and specify file name and press save button. That will save the DPD model to the CSV file. When I set PA power, I use PA output power as a reference. It is common for PA to use PA output or P out as power reference. This means PA output power must be adjusted before making any measurements. Since PA gain varies by input power level, you need to do closed-loop adjustment by measuring PA output power and change SG power level several times to bring the power level to the desired level. This process is called as a power servo. For convenience, there is a power servo mode to automate this closed-loop process in PA mode. You can set tolerance level, and power is automatically adjusted to the specified level. Another common PA measurement is demodulated EBM against different PR levels. It plots graph with EBM in y-axis and Pout in x-axis to show how much EBM changes versus power levels. Power sweep in PA mode provides easy way to make this measurement. You can simply specify start and stop power, size of power step, and which power level to enable DPD. Then, rest is done automatically by restarting measurement. You can also enable power servo to make sure Pout is adjusted at each power steps. As we have seen, making successful PA measurement with DPD requires some considerations. Apply oversampling to the waveform to cover adjacent channels. Memory effect becomes bigger issue as bandwidth gets wider, and memory polynomial is an efficient memory model to use. Adjust PA output before measurements. Power servo is a convenient function to use. To learn more about DPD test solutions, please visit keysight.com. Thank you for watching.